characteristics of human nature. You know, getting attention and attracting people to your business and products is always a challenge, but there are a handful of key traits that are common to all people, all human beings. Show your audience how you can help fulfill them, and you'll have more attention than you know what to do with. Hey, this is Jeff from 10tononline.com. I help small business owners untangle the web so they can build and grow their projects themselves. Now, as business owners and ethical marketers, and I must stress ethical, we can use these five common traits to align our problem-solving solutions, aka our products and services, with the people we seek to help and serve. Let's take a look. Here's the first trait. The first trait is that all people are selfish. All human beings are selfish. Everything we do is out of our own self-interest. This isn't wrong or selfish. It's just how human beings are wired. In fact, it's primal survival-based wiring. We build businesses and are ambitious, really, if you dig deep enough, out of our own self-interest. And the more enlightened among us understand this and use self-interest as a motivator. But we can also set it aside and help others first, the customers, the audience who we seek to serve. Think of it this way. The best kinds of relationships are mutually beneficial, aren't they? Where both parties get their self-interests fulfilled. So both parties have to feel that they're getting what they deserve out of the relationship. Otherwise, they feel resentment. And in business and in life, that's never a good thing. Resentment, that is. Okay, trait number two that is shared with all human beings, or that is common with all human beings, we are all looking for an easier way. We all want to get the biggest results we can with the least amount of effort. In fact, all advancements and progress stem from exactly this. Whether it's Uber or WordPress or medical breakthroughs or a steam engine to pull a plow, all new technologies are created in an effort to get more with less. Said another way, anyone who's given an option between doing something the hard way or doing something the easy way will instinctively choose the path of least resistance. Okay, the third trait, we all want to improve our lives. We are all working hard to improve our current circumstances, our current situation in some way. Whether we're thinking about enrolling in school or trying to reduce our expenses or maybe move to a new city or start a new business or simply going around the corner to get a coffee or relieve boredom, all humans desire to improve their immediate situation. While most people can certainly delay their gratification and go through a little bit of short-term pain, no one would ever volunteer to make their current situation permanently worse than it is right now. All right, the fourth trait. All humans crave certainty. We all want a feeling of reassurance in whatever it is that we're doing. We all want a feeling of confidence that we're making the right choices, believing the right things, and doing the right things in our lives. Unfortunately, this can make a lot of people ignorant and susceptible to cognitive bias. On many issues, people have already made their minds up with just a few scraps, a few breadcrumbs of information. And that's all they need to feel certain that they're right. Okay, the fifth trait, we all demand consistency. We all want predictable, consistent results, both from ourselves and from others. So if a coworker of yours has always come through and delivered, then we expect them to come through and deliver for us again in the future. if fresh coffee has been served every morning at 11:30 a.m. sharp for the past 2 weeks, then we expect fresh coffee today at 11:30 a.m. sharp. We demand consistency from ourselves as well. Whether we hit the gym a few times a week or we hit the bar a few times a week, we demand from ourselves to continue behaving how we are currently behaving. There are many, many more common characteristics and traits that we humans share. Maybe they number in the hundreds, who knows? But if you can help your customers and your market fulfill just these five, then you'll have more eyeballs and more attention than you'll know what to do with. Now, did you enjoy? I hope so. And you know, I've got to tell you, I have a whole lot more I would love to share with you and tell you about. Look, I've been in the business game and in the online game for so long that I love sharing what I've learned with people just like you. You're exactly where I was years and years and years ago. So listen, I have a free online workshop for you that is completely free. Check it out over at 10tononline.com/free. We're big on the free here, and there you'll learn about some of the mistakes and some of the traps that are very common with new business owners. And I'll give you a detailed look at what I call the 10 web building blocks, the 10 pieces that you're going to need to build your successful online business with. We will talk about some of the best ways to start promoting yourself and your business online as well. So get your hands on this free workshop while it is still available over at 10tononline.com/free. I will see you there.